This video is all about reversing into a parking space in a car park, known as bay parking. I already have a video on bay parking, but it's a little bit long. It's about 16 minutes long and goes into real depth. It goes into good detail. This one is supposed to be short and quick to show you where you should be looking, what it should look like out the windows, and what it should look like out your wing mirrors, so that you reverse into a parking space. Also, where you should be steering and how much you should be steering. There is a link in the description for that longer video, which I recommend you watch so you know exactly what you need to do to make sure you pass the driving test. But for the short video, let's get started. There are five steps, and the first thing you need to do is get next to the space you want. So I want this space over here. I'm going to drive up to it. I want to be really close to it, almost like I'm parking at the side of the road, but I'm parking next to the spaces instead. So I'm really close to the front of these spaces. I'm not actually driving in them, close to them. Then I start looking out the side window. And when I feel like I'm sitting, just need to lift my head up to see there, sitting in the middle of the space that I want, my body is in the middle of the space I want, then I know I'm far enough forward. If I go a little bit too far forward, now I'm sitting on the line, the further line of the space, too far forward. If I come back now, this isn't far enough forward because now I feel like I'm sitting on the first line. I want to be sitting in the middle. That's a good start position, around about here. Okay, so that space that we stopped next to, that's the one that we want to reverse into. The one we're sitting in the middle of is the one that we want. The next step is to get the back of our car in line with that space so we can reverse into it. To help you do that, lower the wing mirror closest to the space. As the space is on my left at the moment, I'm going to lower the left wing mirror. And I'm going to lower it approximately this much, just so I can see the rear corner of my car. Then I'm going to steer all the way to the right, which is away from the space. If the space was on your right, you'll be steering to the left. And I'm going to move away from the space, over to the right, until the space is behind me. And you're going to use the wing mirror to know when it's behind you. So I make sure no one's coming. I make sure I'm not going to hit anyone whilst I do this, obviously. And as I move forwards, you can see in the wing mirror, spaces go from being beside you to behind you. Now, the first one that goes behind you is not the one that you were aiming for. You've got to go past that one. It's always the second one. So I'll keep going forward now until the second space behind us gets to around about here. And you can see the front of the space here, that little gap, that represents how far the side of your car is going to be from the line. You want that space to be about 10% the width of the parking space that you're reversing into. If you go too far forward and there's no gap at all like this, that means you're going to end up parking on that line. If you didn't go far enough forward, say you were around about here, there's a big old gap there now, so when you finish parking, you're going to be quite far from that line over to one side of your parking space. What you want, as I say, is about 10% of the front of the space just there, and that's about right. That's what you want to get. So we've done the first two steps. The first step was, this is your space, this is your car, to get alongside and close to your space so that the middle of the space is roughly in the middle of the car. The next step was to get the back of the car in line with your space, and we did that by steering away from the space until back of your car was lined up with the space. Now we're on the third step where we need to get close to the space. To do that, we need to select reverse gear and take the steering off. We want the steering to be straight. We want the wheels to be straight so we can come back. And we're going to use our trusty wing mirror to judge when we're close to the space again. Make sure you're not going to run anyone over and come back slowly until you feel you're close to the space. I would say I'm close to the space around about a little bit more. About there, you can see the front of the space is quite low in the wing mirror. It's right at the bottom of the car. That normally means you're quite close. Now we're moving on to the fourth step. So I've done this, this, and now this. Next thing is to take the angle off. At the moment, my car is pointing that way quite a bit in relation to the space. So I need to point that way more, which means I need to steer that way, which is left. Never think about the front of the car when you're doing this. This is a common mistake most people make. They think, ah, the front of my car is pointing to left, so therefore for me to get straight, I need to steer to the right, because they're trying to control the front of their car and they think steering to the right is going to do that. but it's not going to do that. If you steer to the right, you're going backwards. The back of your car is going to go more to the right, and yeah, you've gone the wrong way. So think about the back of your car. The back of your car is pointing that way, steer that way. In this case, it's all the way to the left. So let's do that. Steer all the way to the left, and then look at the wing mirror again. Make sure you're not going to run anyone over by looking around, and come back gradually now until the line is in line with the car. It's coming around, you see the angle's coming off, it's nearly straight. Go a little bit more, a little bit more, and there, I would say that's straight. The line and the car are as near as, damn it, as straight as a pencil. So, next step, the fifth step, very simply, is just to come back in a straight line. So I'm gonna take the steering off. Wheels are nice and straight now. Again, just make sure you're not gonna run anyone over if you want to, and come back gradually now until the back of the space is at the back of the car. And again, same sort of principle applies. When you feel, when you can see, should I say, that the, turn my reverse sensors off, that the back of the space is at the bottom of the car, which is around about there-ish, perfect. Be a little bit more forward, a little bit further back. Now you're far enough back that you're in the space. Another way you can judge if you're far enough back in your space is to look under the driver's side wing mirror. This doesn't work for the passenger side wing mirror, it only works for the driver's side wing mirror. And what you're looking for is to get the line at the front of the space underneath the wing mirror around about here. If it's here, you're too far forwards, you're not in the space yet. And if the line is behind the wing mirror, around about there, then you've gone too far back, possibly hitting what's behind you. There's only grass behind me at the moment, so I'm okay. So the line needs to be around about there, and I have noticed that in the vast majority of ordinary cars, that works quite well. That works well in like a Fiesta, a Focus, even an Audi TT, as that is very heavily based on a Golf. It's only really long bonnet cars or extremely short bonnet cars where that doesn't work as well. And in a really short bonnet car, if you did that, you'd still be in the space, but you're probably quite near the front of the space, but you will be in it. In a long bonnet car, if you did that, your bonnet's still hanging out, say like a BMW Z4 or a Jaguar E-Type. But for ordinary cars, that seems to work quite well in my experience. So that's the five steps that I use to help teach my customers how to reverse into a parking space. I made that method up myself. I have tried many methods that I've taken from other people over the years, but I found that one to work best. And it didn't start out like that. It started out a bit different, and it has evolved over the years of me doing the job, and it hasn't changed in probably about 2 or 3 years. I'm quite happy with it. It seems to help my customers learn how to do it. It does work. Of course, this method requires you to lower your wing mirrors. And although this car, if I put it in reverse, the wing mirror lowers, only the left wing mirror, lowers automatically. Not all cars do that. Most cars, you can lower them electrically with a little joystick like I've got down here. But there are some cars still where you have a little manual stick. And I can understand if you're not gonna wanna lower your wing mirror if you've got a little manual stick, because they're a real pain in the backside to get back to where you left them last time. If that's the case, you can just lift yourself up. Lifting yourself up is less comfortable, more awkward, but it gives you the same effect of lowering your wing mirrors. If you do lower your wing mirrors though, remember to return them back when you've finished, ready for your driving. If you're practicing without an instructor, make sure you have insurance. Get £20 off via the link in the description to Collingwood, who provides specialist learner insurance that allows you to practice in a friend or family member's car without risking their no claims bonus. If you want to insure your own car, click on the link to confused.com. I have found that they have the widest selection of cheap insurers for young drivers. Well, I hope those five steps help. If you think they do, give the video a like and subscribe to get my future videos. Until the next one, cheerio.